can see here slash 25 means one bit is used. One bit, when you use one bit, so see, this is the network address. When you use one bit, what is the mask? 128. Mask is 128. So one bit means how many host is possible? Networks are possible? Two. How many host is possible? 126. Then what is the valid subnet? Valid subnet is like this. You have to use 256 and this position 128. So I said that time always it starts with the zero. It starts with zero. So zero and 128. Don't proceed further. Only two subnets are possible. So 0, 128. So first host, last host, broadcast. Here first host, last host, broadcast. 255 is a broadcast. It cannot, IP address cannot go beyond 255. Please remember here. So this is the one problem. So now we will proceed to one more. So now we proceed to this problem. I have already explained. See this one. Mask is given 224, 27. Just I have explained you in the previous session. 224 means how many bits I am using. You see here. 3 bits means 224. 5 bits I am using for host. This is host. This is subnet. That means how many subnets are possible? 8. How many host is possible? 30. So how to find out the valid subnet? You have to use the formula something like this. Then table of 32 starts with the 0. See here, starts with 0, 32, 64, 96, 128, 160, 192, 224. If you are interested, you can write entire table. Now, what is the given IP here? So, given IP, you can see, IP is not given, but network is given. 10.0, network is given. So, you can see the scenario also here. Sorry, that I will explain it later. So, IP is not given. So, that's why this is the table you have to draw. And if suppose in this, I will give you problem 192, 168 and 30 dot and I will write here 149 and I'll ask you, this is the IP. You have to find out in which subnet it is coming, slash 27, in which subnet it is coming. So we have solved this problem. So slash 27 table you can see here, in this 149 is coming in this one. This is a subnet. So you have to write, it comes under 192, 168, 30.128 subnet slash 27. And in that 129 is the first IP and 158 is the last, 159 is the broadcast and the number of host possible here. See, number of host possible year to year. How many? 32 host possible, right? So this is the one way. Now, dear friends, we will see one more this one here. You see here, network. We have to classify this one. We have to configure IP address for this network. So you see, router is there and we have one subnet, two, three, four subnets are here. You have to classify. You have to use. And you see, minimum computers are here. And it says here, computer, see, minimum computers like it is a small network. So we have to use first of all class C network for this one. How many subnet? Four subnet. How many bits you have to use? Four subnet means 2 raised to 4 S is equal to 4 alwa. So 2 raised to 4 2 is equal to 4. That is 2 bits you have to use for the subnet. So this is the network position, this is network, sorry, this is network, this is network, this is network in class C, and this is the host position. In the host position, how many bits are there? 8 bits. Out of that 8, 2 MSB bits I will take for subnetting. When you take 2 MSB bits, the rest of the bits I will use for a host. When you take this one for subnetting, so when you take this one, how many bits are left for host? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 bits are left for host. What is the positional value of this one? Positional value of this one is 192. That is 128 plus 64. Positional value. I have already explained in the previous session. That is 192. So you have to solve this one now. How to solve this one? You see here. So you see, two bits I am using, four subnets are possible, 62 hosts are possible. So how to find out the valid subnet? To find out valid subnet, this is the formula you have to use. Then 0 is the first, 64 is the next, 128 is the next, 192 is the next. So here you can see this is the one subnet. This I can assign to one network. This one I can assign to one more network. This one I can assign to one more network. You can see that one here. See here. See here. One network, one more network, one more network, one more network. So this is the second. So my dear students, we will now proceed in this category, last one. So like this, you have to work for 4 bit, you have to work for 5 bits, you have to work for 6 bits, and you have to work for 7 bit also. 6 bit, you see, 30. 30 means mask is 252. 30 means mask is 252. When you take mask is 252, 64 subnets are possible, but only 2 host is capability of the subnet. Now you may ask, what is the use of 2 host? It is very, see, one simple network you need 2 host. Then what is the use of doing subnetting? You may ask. My dear friends, when you connect 2 routers, point to point link, then, see, this is one network. Here your network, here one more network is there. But how you connect it? By means of point to point link, then I need, this is also one network, Alva. This one is one network, here one IP I need, here one IP I need. That means how many IP I need? 2 IPs. So this link is useful for, I'm sorry, this mask is useful for WAN link. WAN link needs only 2 IP. So this mask is useful for WAN link. So you can see here, you can see the valid host. First subnet, second subnet, third subnet, valid host only 1 and 2, 3 is broadcast, 0 is subnet address, so only 2 address possible, that is usually used for only WAN links, so that is the use. So please remember, 25 128 mask. 26, 192, 8 mask. 27, 224 mask. 28, 240 mask. 29, 248. 30, 252 mask. And 25, when you use 1 bit is used and 7 bit is for host. That means block size 128. That means you will get 2 subnet and 126 host. When you use 26 bits, that means you are using 2 bits for networking and 6 bits for host. That means block size is 64. 4 subnet and 62 host. Like this, it will continue. So please put your efforts. Your efforts is required here. So in the next session, we will continue with the class B, subnetworking.